Good morning, happy Sunday, and welcome to another weekly vlog with me and my Kali Bali. We just got home from a wonderful church service, and today for the first time, Colin went into the nursery at church. Before this, we've just held him and he's slept, but now that he is beginning to crawl, he's not going to sit still for an hour or a little over an hour. So we put him in the nursery, and he did so well, so well. Didn't you? You just did so well. You're such a big boy. Look at those beautiful blue eyes. Our playroom area is a disaster zone, so Nora and I are going to tackle that today at some point. Starting to pick it up and clean it up and put our toys away. I think we might do a little bit of a toy rotation situation, and I might take like a bin of toys and put it in the garage and then switch it out in a couple months so they feel new and so that we have fewer toys out full time. But happy Sunday and welcome to our week. We spent the afternoon over at my sister-in-law's house playing with her and her kids, and she has a great backyard, so we spent a lot of time outside. And then we just finished making dinner, so we have grilled Greek pork chops and grilled asparagus and some roasted carrots, red potatoes, and sweet potatoes. Looks like a delicious, springy, summery Sunday night meal. Hey guys, it is a little after 8:30 now. I just got Nora down, and Colin was down, and he just popped back up, so Riley's getting him back down. And I'm standing in my closet, which I always joke is like my little confessional. I always put my camera up here on this shelf, and it's like the perfect height for me to chat with you all. Our dinner tonight was awesome. Those Greek pork chops are just super yummy. I've never liked pork chops. And then when I was home in Maryland a year or two ago, I don't know, a little while back, my mom made that recipe. And I just loved it. And she made it with the pork chops she got in her butcher box. So then I started ordering butcher box pork chops and using the same recipe. So I'll leave it below. It's just a marinade. And then you just grill them. Really yummy. And then the asparagus was just oil, garlic, salt, and pepper. And then we did roasted potatoes and carrots. It was just a really good meal. Very filling, but light. Just perfect. So I wanted to talk about a really sweet thing that happened yesterday on Saturday. I was not vlogging. Riley was putting Colin down for his nap and rocking him down in his room, and Nora started asking to go outside, and so we put on our shoes and went to a local park for, I don't know, 30 minutes, 45 minutes, something like that. This park has a playground, but the playground was really hot to the touch. It wasn't even that hot outside, but the sun had been beating down on it, and Nora's pretty sensitive to heat, and so she didn't want to play on it. So what we ended up doing was just playing, you know, running around in the grass together. And it was like really fun. I tried to do a cartwheel. I think I sprained my wrist, like, you know, but we had a good time. So backing up a couple of days ago, before our adventure to the park yesterday, we were on a walk, Nora, Colin, and me. And we saw one butterfly, this little yellow butterfly fluttered by, and Nora was super excited by it. She kept talking about it and saying that she wanted to see more butterflies. I want to see more butterflies. But there were, so I was like, I don't see any more. I don't see any more. And she just kept asking for more. And I said, well, why don't we pray and see if God will show us some more butterflies? And so I was like, okay, dear God, I pray that we see more butterflies, you know, outside today on our walk. And we kept walking. We walked for quite a while longer, and we didn't see a single other butterfly. And so I just told Nora, you know, God will show us them another time. You know, there's no more butterflies today. So, and yesterday when we went to the park and the playground was too hot, so we ended up just running through like the fields and just the grass. I am not kidding when I say there must have been 25 butterflies that were just like orbiting and swirling around the two of us as we like ran and played it. It truly felt like a scene in a movie. There were big ones and small ones and medium ones. There were white ones and orange ones and yellow ones. They were like beautiful. And they were like, so what we ended up doing is like chasing butterflies. She was like, I'm going to get you, butterfly. And then I would like pretend to run behind her. And we just had so much fun. And it was such a perfect picture, I think, of God's heart for us, in that whenever he says no or not yet, you know, and we patiently wait, he always gives us
abundantly more than we can ask or imagine. When we were taking that walk a couple of days ago, I was just hoping to see one more butterfly. I never envisioned like running through this field where it was just saturated with butterflies, and they like, I truly felt like they were like swirling around the two of us. It was just, it's a precious motherhood memory that I will remember forever. And funny enough, I forgot my phone at home, so I had no way of documenting it, but it's one of those memories, and probably even more so because I wasn't able to take a picture or a video, that's just like seared in my mind. It was just like so beautiful on so many different levels. So I just wanted to share that because it was super special. And then today in church, the sermon was on the Holy Spirit. And so at the end, there was just a time for each person individually, you know, to themselves to just pray and hear from the Lord. And I just saw this. I felt like God put this picture in my head of like a musty house and someone just like throwing all of the windows open in the house, and this like warm breeze just like running like through the windows, through the house. And I very much feel like that it like touched my soul so much. I like understood the symbolism immediately because I feel like sometimes it's easy in the day-to-day and getting caught up in the dishes and the laundry and caring for two kids and diapers and nursing and grocery shopping and meal planning and all the things with work and maintaining our marriage and our home and just every single thing, for life to feel like kind of stagnant and for my faith to then feel kind of stagnant. And I feel like God is moving in my life right now in a fresh wind. Like, I feel like there's just this fresh wind coming in of faith, and I'm like the butterfly thing, and then just these like the like windows being thrown open. It's just all really, it's just been a really good weekend on so many different levels. So I am just feeling very wrapped up in God's love right now, and I'm so grateful for that always. And just feeling like he's moving and new fresh winds and fresh things are coming. And it's just like, it just feels so wonderful. So I wanted to share that because just a couple of special spiritual moments that I've had over this past weekend. So anyway, I'm going to get myself ready for bed and either pop a little bowl of popcorn or have a scoop of ice cream or something. I'm craving a little something. Maybe watch some TV, and then I'm going to head to bed. It's not even, like I said, it's like 8:30, so not quite yet. But I've been trying to get in bed right around 10, between 10 and 11, to get better night's sleeps. So those are all the things I have to say. I'll see you tomorrow. Good morning and happy Monday. I'm up here at my office. We have our babysitter here. Well, not here. We have our babysitter at home with the kids today for a few hours. And I have just been like trying to power and get work done and order Etsy garments and answer conversations. And I was just in the middle of editing a vlog that's supposed to go up this Sunday. So for you, it was like 2 or 3 Sundays ago. And then my computer just started like the spinning wheel of death, you know, because it needs to be updated. So a lot of times when I update my computer, it's, you know, I don't know, 10 minutes or something like that. And it currently says there's still 1 hour remaining. And when I started it a couple minutes ago, it was like 1 hour and 4 minutes remaining. So I am going to relocate over to Riley's studio and get the work done there, and then bounce back here. Originally, I was going to get everything done here, then go there for the second half of my work day, so to speak, but that's not going to work. So I'm going to pack up here, go there, come back here. Welcome to my life. We were supposed to get all kinds of rain last night into today, and it was supposed to rain like pretty much all day today. And I was actually really looking forward to it because I love a good rainy day, especially on a Monday. It's just like a nice, cozy, low-key way to kick off the week. But I don't know if you can tell, it's not raining like at all. Anyway, I'm going to head over there and stop jibber-jabbering here, but I just wanted to say good morning, happy Monday, and welcome to our Monday.
Good morning and happy Tuesday. We just got an early morning grocery delivery. It was all of the normal stuff we've been getting lately, so I didn't share it because there's nothing super interesting in it. Lots of ingredients, fresh fruits and vegetables. Silly toddlers are not included. So this morning I'm going to make some more of this protein Kodiak protein pancake mix. And I bought these for the first time ever in my life. They're called Lily's Dark Chocolate Baking Chips, and they don't have any sugar added into them. And so people say these are great if you don't want to consume quite so much sugar. So I am going to make some chocolate chip pancakes, which sounds like a great meal. And I'm going to get a cup of coffee and get my day going. Happy Tuesday.
So I just finished making my breakfast. I sliced up a whole banana, and then Colin's laughing at me. He's in my arms. And then I just made one large pancake with the mix and the chocolate chips. And I put the chocolate chips into the mix and mixed it up so it's like marbled throughout. Looks so good. A little drizzle of this sugar-free syrup, and I am ready for a yummy breakfast. Also, I just texted my sister and asked for a picture of baby Eliza, and this is what she said. This child looks exactly like Allie, my sister. I mean, they are one in the same. She's going to look just like her mama, but we're not sure what her eyes are going to do because Allie has piercing, sparkling blue eyes, but her husband has brown eyes and her son has beautiful big brown eyes. So we're not sure. Hard to tell still, hard to tell, but look at that cutie patootie. For dinner tonight, while I was up at work, Riley made beef and broccoli with brown rice. This is a Weight Watchers recipe that I found online, so I'll link it below. We haven't tried it yet, but it smells and looks super yummy.
Good morning and happy Wednesday. I don't know if I had any FaceTime on camera yesterday. Yesterday I had a really low mood and was just struggling throughout the day, and I'm not feeling honestly that much better today, but I'm doing the best that I can, so you know, that's something. I did just get these tennis shoes for Nora in the mail. How adorable are they? Let me get my head out of there so they'll focus. They look like little mini real running shoes. So cute. I'll link them below. They're from Zappos and they're purple and they're sparkly. It is sheet washing day in these parts, so that is why the bed has nothing on it, because we are washing sheets today. I don't think there's any one particular reason why I'm feeling like low right now. I think it could be a variety of different things. I would say namely lack of sleep. Both the kids have just been going through some kind of individual growth spurt and have needed a lot of like overnight nighttime parenting. Colin's been waking up to nurse a lot, and Nora's just been having a really hard time sleeping, and so we've just been supporting them through that, of course, but that means that there's very little sleep for us. In other news, if you remember in last week's vlog, I was sharing all of my P.O. Box mail, and I said that I had a yellow slip for one more package. Well, I received it and opened it, and it is from a sweet subscriber named Robin, and it was so heartwarming and so touching. She sent us this waffle cone caramel milk chocolate bar straight from Disney. And we did open it last night and try a little bit. Super delicious and yummy. And this is so thoughtful. She knew that we had looked for this and weren't able to get it. So she got us one of these baby's first Christmas ornaments for Colin. Now, if you watched last week's vlog, you know that another dear subscriber sent us this same ornament. But I'm actually super grateful to have two of them because, not because I'm pregnant with a boy. Don't go there in your mind. No. Because we keep talking about doing two trees and doing one family tree and one Disney tree. And this ornament is like the perfect crossover between a family ornament and a Disney ornament. And so I would love, love, love to have one for each tree. So Robin, thank you so much. Your letter was so dear, and what just a thoughtful, thoughtful gift. And I'm so sorry. It's dated February 19th. I'm so sorry it took me so long to go ahead and pick it up. But I just wanted to let you know how grateful we are for you and for your thoughtfulness. I picked that up yesterday afternoon. As far as last night's dinner, I know that I said I couldn't give a review because we had never had it. 5 stars, 10 out of 10. That beef and broccoli dish was so Sorry, my battery died. What I was saying was that beef and broccoli recipe was absolutely delicious. I can't wait to eat it for lunch today, the leftovers. It was just so good. Riley ended up making the whole thing start to finish. And another reason why I love Plan to Eat is that he has the login to my account. So very often, if he is home with the kids at dinner time while I'm working, he'll just log on and see what I had planned for that night. And usually I will, if I'm on my game, I'll already have the meat thawed out for that. And he'll just go ahead and make dinner. And he has the recipe and everything that he needs right there. And it was wonderful to walk home tonight to a dinner that was prepared. So we just like set the table and sat and ate, and it was so good. My skin, I'm so frustrated. Can you tell in this lighting? A little bit, yeah. I had that like retinol rash that finally cleared up after unknowingly using retinol for weeks on end, which I talked about in a recent video. And I have not used it, and I got the same kind of rash. I've been trying a lot of new products with all of those samples that Ulta mailed me, and I'm thinking that maybe something, one of those had retinol in it, unknowingly I used it, or maybe just had some other something strong. So it'll clear up in a few days, but I woke up and I was like, seriously? But you know, those of you who have sensitive skin know it just takes just a little something to kind of set you off. Not Nora. Colin is taking his morning nap right now and Nora is playing, but I wanted to do a little FaceTime here today since I think I was a little bit MIA yesterday. I am feeling better today. I was really having a hard time yesterday. But Riley, he's always so great about kind of stepping in the gap and helping me out. It was also a frustrating evening. Both of the kids took just hours to go to sleep, which is unusual. Nora usually requires a little extra time for her to go to sleep, like an extra book or just whatever. But Colin's usually pretty quick, but both of them last night, man, they were just fighting sleep, and then they were like up all night. And we didn't have any like caffeine or anything like as a family. It was just one of those things. So I have a hard time sleeping some nights too, but it's frustrating when I'm exhausted and they are both just like awake. All mothers know when you're exhausted and your children won't sleep, that particular brand of frustration where you're just like, okay, so no one's gonna sleep. Good, okay. Anyway, welcome to our Wednesday. I don't have any big plans for the day other than I am gonna go work this afternoon. Riley's planning on coming home in the early afternoon, maybe 2 or 3 o'clock, and then I'll go and work for 2 or 3 hours. I'm just staying on top of things because with my summer line having launched on Etsy, I've had an influx of orders, and so I'm just trying to stay on top of them. So anyway, welcome to our Wednesday. Nora's napping and Kyle and I are hanging out. And Riley just sent me this TikTok. I'm going to show you what it is so that you have a frame of reference, but it made me so emotional. Okay, ready? So it's just like a silly little TikTok. It only doesn't even have that many views. And it's saying like, which Christmas Eve scene would you choose? And it literally made me cry. I got myself together before I turned on the camera. But this, I immediately was like, two, because this could quite literally be a photo. It just reminds me, it takes me right back. This could quite literally be a photo of my childhood Christmas Eves. So every year on Christmas Eve, we would go to my maternal grandmother's house, who we call my mom, who passed away about 2 years ago now. Very sadly, I miss her so much all the time. And she had 9 children. My mom is the youngest of the 9. And then most of my mom and her siblings had children as well.
Yes.
And so there were just all of my cousins and all of my aunts and uncles. And it was just, and she lived in this really cozy, beautifully decorated. It reminds me of this, actually, very much so. Like candles And her dining room had like a beautiful buffet with art above it and a chandelier. She lived in a townhome, so it wasn't like there was tons of square feet, but she just decorated it really so beautifully. And on Christmas Eve, she would just light like taper candles like that all over the whole first floor, and there would always be a huge roaring fire in the fireplace. And we would go at like 6 or 7 o'clock p.m. after Christmas Eve service at each of our different churches, and we would all come and meet there afterwards. So everyone was in their church clothes, and it always smelled so good, like all this amazing food. And the food looked like this because there were so many, many, many people there. And it was, I mean, I've been saying for so long that Christmas Eve is my favorite day of the year. And the reason why is because my heart just goes to those memories. So we would like wake up on Christmas Eve all excited and get all, you know, bathed and showered and dressed and all put on our fancy new Christmas dress or whatever and go to church. And then we would go to my mom's house and have this big Christmas dinner that was always so yummy. And all the adults would bring different, you know, parts of it. And there was always so much food because there were so many people. And my family loves to entertain and to cook. And then all my cousins would be there, and they would upstairs in, they had like a guest, but I guess it would be like a secondary bedroom, but it was set up like an office / mini sitting room. And they would always put on, my grandmother would always put on movies in there, and she would always put on like Chitty Chitty Bang Bang or Sound of Music, because those were her favorites. And there were some toys up there, and we would play, and then we would like sit on blankets and stuff, and like ride down the stairs. And she was used to having 9 kids in the house, so she was like so relaxed and chill about that kind of thing, and we just had the best time. And then even though she had to buy for, I mean, I don't even know, like just in her like family tree, it was probably like in the 30s or 40s of number of people, maybe more. She would buy each grandchild, not one gift, but like a stack of gifts. It was usually little things, but we always felt so special. And then she would buy all of her children and all of their spouses' gifts. So there was just this mound of presents. I mean, like mound, like sea of presents. And every part about Christmas Eve was like my favorite thing in the world. So seeing that little TikTok, I was like, oh, it just like carried me back to these wonderful childhood memories. It was just so, I loved it so much. We don't even like have any like photos of that, because back in the like prime core memory years, like smartphones with cameras weren't a thing. So I mean, we probably took photos as a family in our church clothes before we went to church, before it got dark, because obviously in December it gets dark really early. But I can't recall any, maybe we have a couple, but I can't in my mind picture any photos that we ever took on Christmas Eve at my mom's house. But my memories are so crystal clear, and it brings me back to the coziest, safest, warmest, most peaceful feeling. And I just feel wrapped up in like a warm blanket. But it makes me miss my mom so much. I love her so much. I miss her. She was so spunky and feisty, and she was an amazing entertainer. And I tend to miss her a lot around when I go home for different things. So like we just, obviously, because in my day-to-day life, I never, like down in Texas for the past decade, I never would see her, obviously. But whenever I would go up to Maryland, I would always go see her all through college. And she lived in a home that was, I don't even know if it was a mile away from my parents' house. So I would always see her every time I came home for college, even for a short time. And every time I came home to visit. So like we just had Easter, and I didn't get to go see her. Oh, I just miss her. And that little TikTok just brought me back to some of my very best memories ever of Christmas Eve with all my cousins and family. And like, what a blessing. Oh, I'm like emotional. What a blessing. I didn't even know at the time to have such a big, loving family and a huge table of food and candles being lit and a bunch of presents and just like that, the gift of that kind of warmth and safety. As a child, I didn't even, couldn't even imagine. So that's what I'm thinking about at 1:29 on this Wednesday in May. Is yearning for Christmas Eves of years past. Oh, but I look for those kinds of things make me just so motivated to create super special memories for my babies as they get older. For you. I hope they grow up and have those kinds of, that kind of warm, fuzzy feeling inside about different parts of their childhood, huh? So, there you have it. The next time I'm up there, I really want to go visit her graveside and bring some flowers, and I really want to do that. She loved birds. My mama loved birds. Like, growing up, my mom, they had a bird cage in their kitchen with a bird in it, obviously, and because my mom just always has loved birds, and so, and then, as you guys probably know, cardinals oftentimes are a symbol. Like, people believe that when they see a cardinal, it's a loved one coming back to visit. And my mom said she's never seen more cardinals than since my mom died 2 summers ago. She said she'll be out walking and the cardinal will just kind of follow her along on her walk or whatever. So we feel her presence. It's just missing her and things like that just, like, transport you. So anyway, I'm going to get some lunch because 1:30 and I haven't eaten yet. This crazy boy is so sweet. He's acting so tired, but he will not go night-night, will you? No, but Nora's taking a nap. So we got 1 out of 2 is pretty good. Do you guys have any childhood memories like that where, like, you see something that just triggers your memory in the best way and you just feel, like, wrapped in safety and warmth and love and, like, the innocence of childhood? And we would all, when we were leaving my mom's house on Christmas Eve, we would all not want to leave because all of our cousins were there, and our parents would always be like, well, we have to go home because Santa's going to come. And I just remember still to this day, in fact, I have a candle snuffer here that I inherited, and I specifically said I wanted it because the smell of going around and, like, blowing out candles like that, like snuffing out candles, reminds me so much of Christmas Eve. Because as we were all getting our shoes back on and our big coats and hats and scarves, because it was always freezing cold, and the, you know, grown-ups were going around and snuffing out all the candles that she had lit and helping to clean up and pack up the food and pack up the gifts, the parents would all be saying, and my aunts and uncles and my parents would all be saying, like, we've got to get home. Santa Claus is coming tonight. We've got to get to bed. And it would be like 10 or 11, and we would go home and just put on our PJs and climb into our little flannel sheets. And that was like the beginning of Christmas in a way. You are crazy. You're a crazy boy. You jump in. So anyway, I'm feeling very reminiscent and nostalgic right now. I just wish I could give my mom a hug and she could hold this baby. She never met him. She never met him, and she loved babies. Okay, I'm going to eat food. There you have my sentimental moment for the day. Hello, good morning, and happy Thursday. I'm doing really well this morning, but last night was rough. After the kids went down, I got in bed and was asleep by 9:30. I was exhausted. And by 11:30, my sweet boy was awake, and then he just really never slept. He was just sort of awake all night long. And I would nurse him and get him back down, and then he would wake back up, and then we would go up and down and up and down and up and down, and then he was up for good around like 6:30. So I got some sleep, but it was very piecemeal, and so I'm feeling it this morning. But I had a nice cup of coffee. I had some iced coffee this morning, so good. So I should say a glass of coffee. And then I had my protein pancake that I've been eating that's super yummy and filling. And I just put Colin down for his morning nap and got Nora all dressed and ready, got myself all dressed and ready. And so I'm actually feeling very positive and ready to take on this day, even though I really got like no sleep last night. So that's that. I don't know the last time I picked up the camera, it might have been crying and reminiscing about Christmas Eve of years past. But after that, I went up to my office yesterday afternoon for about 4 hours and got a whole bunch of orders packaged up. I got my weekly vlog that's going to be live this Sunday. So for you, it will be like 2 weeks ago or something. I forget how many weeks ahead I am. But I got that one done and scheduled is the word that I am looking for. And answered some emails, and I reopened my mentorship program. So I've been communicating with mentees that I have sessions with here in the next couple of months. I have it open through the end of May and all of June, and I will continuously reopen spots about 2 to 3 months at a time. So I'm really looking forward to getting back into that. I've missed it so much, but without regular childcare and with a newborn, it was not an option for me for a little while, but now I'm back to it. So I will leave a link to more information and how to schedule a session below. And I really look forward to meeting some of y'all and working with you through my mentorship program. It's going to be really fun. It's always so rewarding. I just love it. It's one of my very favorite things that I do. So today, we were under a tornado watch until 10 p.m. last night, and then we never had, I don't even know if we got any rain, but the weather outside is still very weird, and I guess it might still pour rain in the next couple of hours, so I'm not exactly sure. So I think we're probably going to stay inside today and not do too much outdoor play, because getting caught in a rainstorm slash tornado sounds like not my idea of a good time. Oh, hi, Charlie Bear. Let me show you Charlie. He doesn't get very much airtime these days, but we still love him. Here he is.
Hi, Charlie Bear. Are you just getting your morning started, big boy? How old are you gonna? You're gonna be 9 this September. 9 years old? You've been with me through it all. Through it all, Bubba. Through it all. I got Charlie in December of 2013. He was 6 weeks old, and I was single and living in Austin, so he has truly been with me through every single thing. He is, like, still in absolutely perfect health, aren't ya? Aren't ya?
I want to do it. Good job, Nora! Typing! Now you need to get her a type.
We spent about an hour up at Riley's office this morning just visiting with him and seeing his mom up there too, because it's a family business. And when I got home, I had a big bouquet of flowers waiting for me from Liquid IV, of all people. And they sent them to me for Mother's Day. So, so sweet, along with a pack of the watermelon, which we've been out of because that's one of our very favorites. So I'm going to clip the stems on these. It's a beautiful bouquet, and put it in this vase here. But that was just so sweet. It's from a company called Fresh Stems. Oh, Fresh Sends. It's cute. And they even have like a Liquid IV newspaper wrapping it up. I just am so delighted by this. Thank you, Liquid IV. And thank you for supporting me in my motherhood journey. Because I have a Liquid IV every single morning, and it makes such a difference. In fact, here's mine from today, just a little bit left at the bottom. It is a little after 3:22 to be exact, and I just finished making dinner. This is what we are having for dinner tonight. It is a decidedly fall autumnal meal, but it just sounded really, really good. So I just made it, and I had 2 cans of pumpkin left over from the fall, and I decided to just go ahead and use it up and make this pumpkin and sage stuffed shells dish, so I'll have to let you know how it is. But I did taste the filling and the sauce, because you make both of those things separately before you, you know, assemble it. And they were both delicious. So that is what we are having for dinner tonight. I will leave a link to the recipe below, and I'll let you know later what we think of it. So here is dinner all finished. You'll notice that these are not stuffed shells, but it's the exact same recipe. I just piped the filling into big rigatoni because I did not have any shells, and when I went to the grocery store to pick some up, they were out. So this should work just as well. So it's sort of like a baked ziti, but it's rigatoni and it's stuffed, so maybe not quite so much. But here are the Liquid IV flowers. So beautiful. And we're gonna sit down and eat. We wrapped up dinner, which was really yummy. It will be so good in the fall months. I'm definitely bookmarking that recipe for later this year. And I am up in my office, and I have a lot of garments to organize and sort through and ship out from my summer line launch. So I pulled some of my favorites so I could show you some of the new designs in case you are interested. So this new design we are calling Flower Bike, and this is on a seafoam. Lighting is so hard. Really the best lighting. This is really the best against this lighter background. But you can get it on any color, pretty much any color. If you get it on a darker color, it will not pop as much. But it's so cute. It has little flowers in the bike basket embroidered in there. And then we have Vacay Mode, and this tee is a lagoon color. I'm telling you the colors in case you like the combination. Nora's toys are on the floor. And you want to find it, that's that. But you can order any of the designs on any of the colors. This one is These Are the Days embroidery. This one is All Things New. This is a blue spruce. This is berry. And then we have a couple of new screen print designs. We have this one, which is Weekend. This is on a white sweatshirt, but it also comes on t-shirts or long sleeve tees. And same with this one, which is Motherhood. And then these are not new for my summer line, but these are our best sellers in the summer, so I thought I would show you them in case they strike your fancy. So we have the castle embroidery with the fireworks. I love this one. This is on a flow blue. This is Airplane Mode, which is super popular during the summertime when people are traveling. And this color is called Watermelon. And then this one is See You Soon, which is perfect for anyone who's going on a cruise or going to the beach. And this color is Seafoam. It's the same color as the Flower Bike. So those are all of those. We also have, let's come over here, on a mustard tee, a design that says Chasing Sunshine. That's really cute. Let's see, are there any others? This one, Seeking Sunshine, is also really popular for obvious reasons during the summer. And I think that's pretty much covers it. I mean, there are many, many more designs. We have, you can get the seashell embroidered in white. So you can get it on like navy. And then you can get the seashell embroidered in navy. So this is like on lagoon. Somebody's even ordering the little ghostie, which is one of our Halloween designs. Someone else is ordering. People order the holiday designs all year long. I mean, this one, if you are like Irish or if you're into, you know, this kind of thing, you could really wear it anytime. But it was a St. Patrick's Day launch from last year. This Favorite People, Favorite Place is really popular for folks who are traveling during the summer and going to their favorite place with their favorite people, obviously. Anyway, Exhale is really popular. I need to clip it. Sometimes the thread is long and I have to clip it, but that's on a black sweatshirt. That's really popular during summertime. It's the little things. Rest Day is great for when you're relaxing and unplugging. Make Waves is another great summery one. So anyway, I need to organize these, fold these, sort these, ship them out. But that is what I'm up to. Also, we have, this is from when I was photographing it, we have one that, says paused. It's screen printed. And so this is on a chalky mint tee, but you can get it on anything, including like a sweatshirt. So that's a fun one too, if you just need to like take a deep breath. All right, I am going to get to packaging some orders. All right, I have pre-packaged all of the orders that I'm going to be mailing out first thing tomorrow morning, and I'm going to be packaging up tonight. It's about 40-ish orders total, so I'm gonna go ahead and get them packaged. I have a long ribbon of shipping labels below, but I obviously can't show you them because they've got addresses on them. It's about 9:30 now. I'm thinking I could probably get these finished up by 10, and then I'm gonna head home and get some sleep.
Good morning and happy Friday. It's about 10:30 right now in the morning. I just hopped out of the shower and pulled myself together. I feel very refreshed. I love getting a good hot shower. Nora is up. I hear her footsteps, so I think she's shuffling on up here. Colin is taking his morning nap, and sadly, Riley is feeling under the weather this morning, so he is actually still in bed. The kids and I have been up since 7, but at 10:30, him being still in bed is an indicator that he's definitely not feeling well. So He's been feeling congested and kind of like allergies, sinus stuff for the past few days. So I don't know if that's caught up to him and he just has more of a cold or a sinus infection or if it's something else. So I'm just going to let him sleep until he, you know, feels up to getting up, and then we'll have a conversation about whether he needs to head into the doctor or, you know, what to do about that. So there's definitely a few little bugs going around, little like coldy kind of bugs. Nora had one recently, and looks like Riley has one too.
No baby bugs.
Oh, Nora says no baby bugs. No, I'm talking about daddy being sick. Yeah, daddy being sick. Last I talked to you, I believe, was last night when I was up at my office. I got a whole lot done last night. That was really, really nice. And it's always nice to go to bed feeling like I accomplished something big off my list. That's such a struggle for me with parenting small children, is that really tending to them is really the only real thing I can usually get done in a day when I don't have extra hands, when Riley's not watching them or babysitter's not watching them. And that's really hard for me. Like, I can get the dishwasher done and maybe start a load of laundry, but like, my normal level of productivity is significantly diminished while I'm caring for them, because of course the prioritization then is just to care for them. But I really like crossing things off lists. And so it was a long parenthood day yesterday, and getting up to my office. You're going to ride the bike. Getting up to my office in the evening and actually checking a few things off, answering emails, getting caught up on Etsy, packaging a bunch of orders. I finished editing a vlog, like all of that. It feeds me in a way that tending to little ones all day just doesn't. That feeds me in a different, more important way, but I think a lot of you probably can relate and know what I'm saying. So that's something I've been contemplating a lot since I have been doing my friend Hannah's course, which I will link below, the Present Mama Playbook. I was talking about it a whole lot in last week's video. She talks about the inconvenience of motherhood and how motherhood was never meant to be convenient. And I have contemplated that a lot lately because she's so right. That like, when I feel like motherhood is inconvenient, it's because it absolutely is. And it's not meant to be convenient. And that's a big part of it, is bending to other folks, my kids, you know, rather than my own will and everything that comes along with that. So just some deep thoughts for this Friday morning. Anyway, welcome to our Friday.
Here comes Nora on her bike. Girlfriend, your helmet. Whoa. Your helmet's not all the way on. You gonna put your helmet on correctly? All right, sissy. You ready to go?
Yeah.
Okay, show Mama how you can ride your bike.
Ride
the bike.
Bye, Mama, bye.
Bye, sweetheart. Have a fun day. It is now 1 o'clock in the afternoon. I still have not seen Riley. He has been in bed sick all day, so he must really, really not be feeling well. So I made him a little lunch on a tray. I'm going to carry it in there in a second. I just made grilled cheese with a pickle and some crackers and just some like Campbell's chicken noodle soup. And then in that turbos is a watermelon liquid IV, because I figure he could probably use some electrolytes. And then I'm going to see if he's taken any medicine. I'm assuming not, because he literally hasn't left the bed. And then I'll get him. Bless you, Bubba. I'll get him whatever he needs. So, gotta take care of your people when they're sick. I feel so sad for him.
All right, lunch has been delivered to Riley. He's okay. He's just feeling really stuffy. Feels like maybe he has like a sinus infection or something like that. His head just feels really full and heavy. Is that right? Is that so right? Colin took a 2.5 hour nap, and Nora is taking a really good nap. So Riley just ate the lunch that I made him, and then I feel like I'm really blue right now. And then I made him some hot tea with honey and lemon, and so he's sipping on that. And I turned on Star Wars for him in our bedroom, so he's recovering, you know, and just resting. Do you want this on you? Is that the problem? Oh, hi. Oh, hi, little boy. You need to get dressed. We haven't even gotten you dressed yet. It's 1 o'clock. So he'll be okay. He took some, like, allergy, sinus, cold and flu, something, medicine, just now that I brought him, and he'll be just fine. But I know when you feel like that, you really truly just want to lay in bed and sip on something warm and hydrate and rest. And that way he can bounce back and feel better soon. So we're letting him do that. I'm going to try to keep the kids as quiet as I can. Nora's still asleep, of course, so that he can get as much rest as he needs so that he can feel better. And I'm just going to get some things done around the house. I'm going to go change him into some real clothes because he's still in PJs from last night, aren't you, cutie patootie? And I have a little bit of laundry to do and stuff like that. But it's always sad when somebody's sick.
We are out taking a walk on this beautiful, beautiful afternoon. Nora's down here with her baby. You have your new sparkly purple shoes on?
Yeah.
They're so cute. And Mama's got some Gatorade. And we are walking, aren't we, Kali? Look at those beautiful eyes. Whoa. I am in my, what do I call it? Confessional, is that what I call this? Not a confessional. I always joke that if I were on reality TV, this is the spot where I would do my video diaries. That's probably a better way to say it. Here I'm in my video diary spot. I am using my phone to film because I left my camera in the other room and I have my phone with me and that's it. It's been a long, tiring day. Taking care of the kids and Riley. He's starting to feel a lot better this evening and I don't mind at all taking care of him, but I'm personally worn out. I was up with the kids at like, it was earlier than 7 a.m. and have just been, you know, doing it all day. So I'm definitely going to get a good night's sleep tonight. Hopefully everyone else gets a good night's sleep and hopefully Riley wakes up feeling nice and well rested. I do have a meeting with a mentee tomorrow morning around 11, so I'll be able to have some time in the morning to, you know, get some things done around the house, maybe spend some time outside with the kids, and then I'll go and have my meeting just before noon. I think it's 11:15 to 12:15, so I'm really looking forward to that. I always love meeting my mentees and working with them. It's just truly such a highlight for me of my whole life, really. Love it. Anyway, I'm gonna go to bed and I will see you guys in the morning.
Good morning and happy Saturday. I am feeling so much more well rested today than I was by the end of the day yesterday. I was pretty exhausted. But that's like the end of every day. I was like joking with Riley that even if I drank 3 Red Bulls at 9 p.m., I could probably fall asleep at 9:30 because this part of my life, as many other young mothers know, like it's just every day is exhausting. It's just a lot all day long in good ways and in hard ways, but it's just the reality of it. Riley woke up this morning feeling great. He feels completely great. He's like, my nose is still a little stuffy, but I feel completely back to normal. So we're really grateful for his health returning, and I'm glad that he was able to take most of yesterday and really just rest, because honestly, that's what your body needs to do when you don't feel well. So I'm obviously up at my office. I am about to meet with a mentee here in about 35 minutes or so. I'm really excited to meet her because this is someone who has been a longtime subscriber and supporter and online friend, and I am so excited to meet like face to face over Zoom, and she is wanting to start her own YouTube channel. So you know who you are if you're watching this, but I'm really looking forward to having that conversation and all of that. I will link the information about booking a mentorship session with me below. I have dates, as I said previously in this vlog, through the end of May and all of June, and I will continue to open up dates throughout July, August, September, and so on and so forth as time goes on. I'm hoping to have this long-running open mentorship and not have to close it down. Of course, the 2 times that I have closed it down were in the wake of Nora's birth and in the wake of Colin's birth. I do not plan on getting pregnant anytime soon. And maybe not ever again. So no worries there. We will be open. So go ahead and book a session with me if you'd like. And there's information there if you have questions, what you can do about that, and just kind of more information in general if you are interested. I will make sure to leave a link to everything that I mentioned in this video below. So you can check those things out if you are interested in anything that I've mentioned in this video.
Trying to think if there's anything else. The only other thing is Hannah Olsen's Present Mama playbook that I talked about heavily in last week's vlog and bumped on, you know, a little bit, talked about in this week's vlog. I'm not sure if by the time this video goes up, it might actually be live, but I know for sure that I can leave more info about it below. So you can either sign up for the wait list and she will let you know when the course is open, or you can go ahead and sign up. I can't explain to you how impactful that course has been and is continuing to be. I just highly recommend it. If you are a mom in the trenches and you need some encouragement and some really good practical tips, like, I'm loving this course. So I will leave it linked below. Anyway, I hope you guys are having a great day, a great week, wherever you are. Here in the US, tomorrow is Mother's Day. So by the time this goes up, it's been a few weeks, but happy Mother's Day to all kinds of mothers out there. And if you are a family waiting for your baby, I just want you to know you have an extra special place in my heart this week in particular, but always. So I'm sending a big hug, lots of love, and I'll see you guys next Sunday.